shards of cloudstone. Other unique things are sticky white stuff, which is a buff. He sells the scimitar and falchion, which we don't need. And I think leather shield is only obtainable as in a starting class weapon otherwise, so that's pretty cool. He has the leather armor as well, if you're interested in that. But we don't have any business.
A bit of indulgence goes a long way.
The good thing, though, is when you unlock this jail cell, he moves later to his final location, which is later on in this world. I mean, it's not essential. It's really not that effective at all for anything, but it's still cool, I guess. There's another illusory wall around here. I think it's this one. This one. These close range ambushes by these skeleton guys are so dangerous if you don't have the output that I have. The damage output that I have is basically like fucking cheating. It's such a huge exploit, but if you don't have this damage output, you're gonna get destroyed by these skeleton guys. They are so buff. They are so buff. It's totally bullshit. What the fuck? I'm back here? Oh, I remember this. Okay. I didn't do that part. What's your favorite Yoshimitsu outfit? My favorite Yoshimitsu outfit is Tekken 3, actually. The same outfit that they used in Tekken Cross Street Fighter. That's my favorite outfit, actually. But Tekken 2 was cool, too, because Tekken 2 was the last time where he had human skin. One of these is also an illusory wall, right? Am I tripping? Isn't there another one somewhere? Damn, I guess I am tripping. How the fuck do you get to the bird's nest? I'm missing something here. I forgot. There's some way to get up to that bird's nest. Yeah, this game has weapon durability. Ah, here it is. Okay. So this bird's nest has a similar function to that sparkly
give
shit.
Give sparkly me. Give twinkly me. Me. You. Trade. Trade. Give me sparkly twinkly.
Does MP regenerate in this game automatically, or does it come back when you die? It comes back when you die. It does not regenerate automatically unless you're wearing an item that regenerates it. In the case that, in my case right now, I have a couple of items that do that. I started with the Royal, so I started with the Fragrant Ring, which replenishes my MP. I also started with the Silver Coronet, which replenishes my MP. And there's a third item that is exclusive to female characters. I forget what they're called, but it's a gauntlet set that raises your MP, and it all stacks. So it's pretty cheap. Anyway, you can trade some shit with this bird. Augite of Guidance might be one of them. I don't remember what it particularly gives me, but one thing that I know I can trade with the bird that I will get another one of later, just to show you guys what it does. Oh, I don't have it with me. You can trade the Talisman of Gods to it. And you get, like, I forget what you get. Colorless Demon Souls or something. Either way, that's where the bird is. And this is, I think, where the gecko is. No, it's not. That's not where it is. The gecko is a drop down from where the bird is. Which is here. And the drop down is...
You scared me.
Remember, there's no falling attacks. So, damn, did you see this guy fucking bone out? Don't leave the scene, bitch. I got questions. Boom. Nice. Okay. So now we gotta go back to where that was to get the treasure. It's down here. Down here. Make a right. Make another right. Nope, sorry. Make a left. Then a right. Nope. Then a left. And then... What? I went the wrong way. I should have made a right turn at Albuquerque. There we go, right? Right. Okay. So this is where we were a second ago. Oops. Hey, anybody who has suggestions on games they want me to play, I'm always open-minded. I definitely won't play whatever the fuck you want me to play. And I'm very picky. But I'll at least consider it. Just let me know. I have a Twitter. That's the best place to recommend games to me. My Twitter's Avoid the Puddle. So if you guys want to recommend something, just do it on there. So that's it. I pretty much cleared out the whole area, right? We could go the regular way. Just to make sure, but I'm pretty sure I picked everything up. You know, there's always something you forget, I guess. Like that. I knew it. Anything else? I've already played PT. My whole playthrough is on my YouTube channel. I threw my controller, I got so scared. That's where this GIF's from. This GIF is me throwing my controller while playing PT because I got spooked so hard. I'm not even kidding you. Can you believe I did that? My PS4 was brand new at the time. Anyway. I think, it's time for a short break. The game was spooky as fuck. Anyway, give me a second. Let me look at some flowers, will you, Lord Chatroom? Just a moment. Yeah, I've played Dino Crisis. It's alright. Just a sec. Okay, I'm back. Lords of the Fallen sucks. Yeah, I played that game for about 9 hours. It's not as bad as Dying Light. Dying Light was terrible. I played that game for 4 hours. It was putrid. But Lords of the Fallen, you know what really blew it for me is when I watched a speedrun of that game. I was like, oh no. The way they did it was they just used the shield and they just hold it up and run full speed into every enemy. And if you hold up your shield while you're running, if you have it upgraded enough, you'll just knock everyone down. So you can just kill everyone with your shield by holding it up and running into them. That game sucked. The combat was so slow, too. Clunky ass, shitty combat. I'm looking forward to the PC release of Dragon's Dogma. 60 frames per second sounds pretty cool. You can hear the gecko, but where is it? I think it's over here. I forgot a gecko. It's over here. Damn, I'm glad I could hear that gecko. It's what reminded me that it even existed. It's out here. Fuck you, bitch. Come back here. I hate geckos. I hate geckos. Fucking don't leave the scene, motherfucker. Oh no! Careful! Don't ricochet! Oh my god, the fucking... the cliff! Jesus Christ! Ugh! Stupid ass bitch geckos. Oh, that was a drop down. So we're back here again. And this guy's alive still, but he should be no trouble. Okay, so we got 17,000 souls. We definitely want to cash those in. I don't need any trouble. What's up, Val Fodder? It's almost 1 a.m., Lord Chatroom. I'm running out of gas. It's getting late.
Thou seek then time.
Seek a
soul of the
power.
Mind, key to life's ether. Soul of the lost, drawn from its
could do endurance.
Vessel.
Have I defeated the art stream and shit yet? No. That's what I want to do. I want to do that. And I want to beat the penetrator. So maybe I still got some gas left in the tank, Lord Chatroom. Just hang in there, will ya? Forgive me if my charisma levels have dipped. Have taken a dive. What's up, Kenny? Long time no see. Let's see here. Increased vitality, endurance... That's good.
Art thou done?
Thou art done. So now that I defeated that, I mean I cleared out that area and picked up all that shit, I could go to Stockpile Thomas and deposit all the upgrade materials. Going to Domino's tomorrow. What should? I assume the rest of that sentence is, I get. At Domino's, you know, honestly, I think Domino's Pizza is kind of weak, but if they have a deal, I like to get pepperoni, mushroom, jalapeno with extra sauce, but if they have the 50% off deal, the best strategy is to get the Extravaganza Feast, which is one of their specialty pizzas. And then what you do is you order online, and you order the Extravaganza Feast, but you... remove all the toppings and hand pick the toppings yourself. The reason you're picking the extravaganza feast is because it has the most number of toppings on it. So if you can get 50% off at Domino's, which happens periodically, you want to order the extravaganza feast online through the website, and it has like 8 toppings on it. It's the most number of toppings on any of their specialties. And then you hand pick the toppings you want. So you could get an 8 topping pizza for $10 extra large at Domino's. I'm sharing the secret Domino's strategies with you. Triple pepperoni is really good too. I love triple pepperoni. I've gotten that many times. Yeah, I got some secret pizza straps. Yeah, strats. 8 toppings is no joke at Domino's. 2 medium, 2 toppings for less than 15 is not that good. I don't like Domino's that much. It's decent. It's decent. It's not terrible. But I think at Domino's Pizza, extra sauce really goes a long way because their pizza is a little bit dry. So extra red sauce really goes a long way, in my opinion. Anyway, you'll notice that Ostrava has now come into the Nexus. He's chilling here.
At its peak, Boletaria was a grand kingdom. The king, his knights, and his subjects were modest and plain, but also steadfast and compassionate. In the distant southern kingdom, Boletaria was known as paradise on earth. But look at what has become of us now. I refuse to believe that this is what
fuck this guy and whatever the hell he's talking about. Hypothetically speaking, right? If you wanted to and you were not using that coupon, that same pizza would cost you $20. Honestly, that's not that bad of a deal. To be perfectly honest with you, $20 is not that bad for an 8 topping extra large. I could see it. Why not? Go for it. But honestly, you know, if you're going to spend $20 on pizza, you could get 2 pizzas of the same size from Costco. And you know what you could do at Costco? That's top secret. You're not going to like this, Lord Chatroom, if you guys are new. So if you guys know about Costco, you know that their pizza is really good. I think it's an 18-inch pizza or something for $10, $9.99. But your options are either cheese, pepperoni, or supreme. Cheese and pepperoni are very self-explanatory. But supreme, it has pepperoni, mushroom, sausage, onion, and bell pepper. I personally am not a big fan of sausage, onion, and bell pepper. So if it were up to me, I would order pepperoni and mushroom and lose the sausage, onion, and bell pepper. But did you know that you actually are able to do that at Costco? If you call in, you can ask them, hey, I would like a pepperoni and mushroom, and they will make it for you. Another secret about Costco that you may not know is that everybody knows Costco has hot dogs for $1.50. And at their condiment bar, they have ketchup, mustard, onions, relish, and deli mustard. But did you know that you can ask the ladies at the counter, you can ask them for sauerkraut, and it's free. Sauerkraut is a secret condiment that they have at Costco for your hot dog. It's totally free, but it's just not available over the counter. You have to have a prescription from Dr. Aris, and I just wrote you a prescription. Enjoy. That one's free of charge. The next Costco strat, you're gonna have to pay serious dinero for that one. Shh. Let's concentrate on the game. So, we're gonna replace, or deposit, I should say. Oh, we already did that. Then in that case, we can move on with stage 2. What's up, Lord Chatroom? How you guys doing? Everybody having a good one? C- Costco lore. Yeah, man. That's the secret lore. It's etched into the catacombs. This fucking bitch. He's dead. Now we can get the rest of these fucking street toughs. Look at these guys just chilling out here. Smoking reefer. Oh god, who said that? Nested loops? Ooh, close call. Thanks very much, Nested Loops. Muchos Garcias. I really do appreciate that. That's a new name. I've never seen that name before. Lord Chatroom, put some extra sauerkraut on those hot dogs. Nested Loops, you must really appreciate the top secret strategies that I shared with you. Thank you so much. Use them wisely, my friend. Oh no! Fuck! It's okay, it's right near the beginning, no problem. Subscribing for more Costco tips. Thanks very much, Nested Loops. Whew, I don't really have that many Costco tips. Honestly, I've never owned a Costco card. I only have Costco strats for, you know, like, going there to eat. I've been there a million times. I used to go with my dad, like, every week to Costco to eat hot dogs and pizza and shit. But I've never had a Costco card for grocery shopping. You know? Anyway, thanks again for subscribing. I really appreciate that. Very, very kind of you. Are you playing Demon's Souls in 60 frames per second? That is such a noob question. Demon's Souls is not available in 60 frames per second. It doesn't exist. That's like ordering a six-pack of Skittle Brow. Such a drink does not exist. Oh my god, would you guys? Shh. This is all your fault. Just getting me talking, yippity yapping, instead of focusing on these lizard men. Stupid bitch. Oh my gosh. You guys are gonna one-shot me if I fuck up. There we go. What were we talking about? Murden Hammer. I actually want to just beat the boss right away. There is so much loot in this stage. It's crazy. This game has quite a bit of treasure just in general. You gotta be careful where you drop down here. This first cliff with this archway here, this area has a world tendency event tied to it. When you're in pure black or pure white, this area has a dude here who's a real douchebag. Because if you fuck up, he'll never show up. But this dude in pure white world tendency, this is the only guy who will ever drop a pure clear stone. Whatever. A pure clear stone. He will only drop that here. And if you fuck that event up, he'll never drop it. It sucks. And that means you cannot upgrade your crushing battle axe or anything to crushing plus 5 until new game plus. It's really bullshit, but that's the way the game's designed. World tendency events could go fuck themselves. But, I mean, that's the whole point. For them to go fuck themselves. Unbelievable. That gecko's gone. Fuck it. This is gonna be the boss. It should be pretty easy, but I might die. We'll see. That item over there, is the Hands of Gods. The Hands of Gods or God? Either way, I don't need it. It's a strength weapon. Are you going to the next Wednesday night fights? I don't know, maybe. I don't really plan ahead like that. But we'll see. I'm definitely not gonna go there if I don't feel like it. And I'm definitely not gonna go there if it's not like Alex Viad doesn't want me to be there in terms of like for commentary. If either of those things does not happen, then I probably won't go. Anyway, so I'm gonna use the crisp blade here in my left hand because I'm pretty sure fire doesn't count as magic. But maybe it does. Either way, I'm also going to use the Thieves' Ring because it helps with running from him. Excuse me. Here we go. Wish me luck, Lord Shadrim. It should be easy, actually. So because I'm wearing the Thieves' Ring, I think, he can't see me in the beginning of this, which is fine. You want to walk over here, you can easily cheese this guy out. This rib cage here, he can't run into it. And because I'm a magic user, I'm pretty sure all I have to do is pull out my wand and put this shit right in his butthole. Toast. So you can cheese this guy out. Especially for a magic user. But even if you're not a magic user, you could cheese this clown out, no problemo. Eventually he'll grow a brain and he'll run around, but he's basically a moron. The boss is relatively easy if you don't even cheese him. His move list is really unimpressive in general. But if you're new, I mean, he'll terrorize you. Hey, what's up, Glaive, bro? I'm sure everybody's gonna call you a Studebaker. Don't get butthurt, man. Anyway, let's finish him off with some good old-fashioned fucking up, and then some good old-fashioned me getting wrecked. I like his music. Flame Lurker's music is awesome. Anyway, welcome to the chat room. Red Hot Demon Soul. Return to the Nexus. How's it going, Glaive, bro? What's the latest word on the streets? Studebaker just means you're new around here, man. The word Hagrid is banned in the chat room, so when someone comes in and says, hey, you look like Hagrid, everybody in the chat room knows, oh, this guy must be new. Let's call him a Studebaker, make him feel uncomfortable, and eventually, he'll be calling other people Studebakers. So soon enough, Glaive bro, you're gonna be like, hey, look at this fucking asshole making the Hagrid observation again, huh? Boom, spam the Studebaker emoticon. That's how it works around here. Welcome. What's up, Avoid Best Haircut? What's up, Kozu? What's up, Bee Snipe? What's up, War Cat? How's it going, everybody? Let's deposit all this heavy-ass shit I'm carrying. Deposit. pause it this thing. I think that's it. We got a lot of souls to level up with, though. The Maiden in Black is always moving around in the Nexus. Super annoying.
Soul of the mind, vitality, right? Life's ether. Soul of the lost. Art thou done?
You guys know the rules. As I said many times, every time you beat a boss, you have to die in the Nexus. So that you don't fuck with the world tendency. But I feel like if I don't repeat it every time, someone who's new in here will be like, why did he just kill himself? So yeah, this game has a world tendency function. And in order to protect yourself from accidentally fucking it up permanently, you should kill yourself in the Nexus every time you're in living form. Because the Nexus doesn't affect the world tendency. What's up, Blue Evac? Man, this game's so cool. I forgot what time I started streaming. I think I started around, like, before 9. And now it's almost 1. Fucking time flies when you're having fun. Okay, so next thing I gotta do is kill the dragon god. You know, this is always a pain in my ass, and I don't know why. This is always a struggle for me. It really is. I don't know why. I've done it perfectly, like, several times, but in recent history, this boss has ruined my butthole. Take it easy, BG Pope. Is there any items in here? I think there's a treasure right here, yeah. And here, nice. These little puddles of lava, they will deal damage if you're standing in them. So, see? It's a part of the fight. I'm just checking the rest of the room for treasure. What's up, Petulian Gray? What's up, Lord Chatroom? Who said that? You know, I never noticed these flames up there. I never noticed that. What the hell is up with those flames up there? Out of interest. What didn't you like about Witcher 3 when you saw it? Well, I never played it, but from the look of Witcher 3, it looked really slow, and it also has a very linear storyline, and it's the type of game where you don't create your character has a name, and all those signs pointed towards, you know, get it when it's really cheap. I'll probably play Witcher 3 when it's under $10. I think it's worth me trying out for under $10. But games like Witcher and Shadows of Mordor and, you know, games like that, I haven't really been interested in those games. But I'll try it, though. I'm open-minded to try it. I want to try it. So when it's really cheap, I'll give it a whirl. Also, you know, when The Witcher 3 came out, I didn't have a pimps-only graphics card. But since then, I've upgraded my graphics card to a pimps only GTX 970, so I could easily play it. I don't know if my PC would crash. By the way, last time I fucking streamed, my PC crashed for no reason. So, if my PC ends up crashing for some reason, sorry everybody. I felt so bad too because there were so many new people in here. I was like streaming for like 16 or 1700 people and my PC crashed. So I couldn't even tell them, like, see you later, thanks for watching. Which sucks, but whatever. Good night, Char. Charles is going to bed. Oops. Charles is my roommate, by the way. Uncharted. Excuse me. So, I don't know if this is the best way to do it, but the way I've been doing it is you pick up the Dragon Bone Smasher and you run past. That's it, right? I mean, that's what you do. Pick up the Dragon Bone Smasher and you run past. Let's see if that's really what you're supposed to do. Right? That's exactly what happens. That's exactly what happens if you fuck it up. Shit. You can shoot magic at them? Oh yeah, I forgot about that. I never use magic, so I never use that strategy. That's a great strategy, actually. Thanks for the tip. I forgot that I have magic. Having access to projectiles in this game really changes everything. Makes it much easier. Which is usually why I refrain from any kind of magic or bow usage. Just because it's more fun. But once you've played a game so many times, it's kind of like you want to try the other things that the game has to offer. That bullshit that just happened right now. Wow, you have to shoot it that many times? It's gonna take all day. That's ridiculous. I can't believe you have to hit it that many times. I think you can just do that attack and it'll break through. I thought that if you just do the forward L1 with a curved sword, you auto break through the rocks. But maybe I have to two-hand it? I don't remember. I always get wrecked on this stupid boss because I got a bad memory. This boss, all you have to do is have a regular human's memory and you'll beat it every time. But if you got the memory of a shark like me, it's like the first time every time. That doesn't work. So you reach this first ballista. This boss is weird. It's basically like you can't do real damage to him. You just have to reach this ballista without getting killed. And then you get, there's one more ballista. And once you hit him with both, then you can land the killing blow. What's up, David Sonis? So, normally you're supposed to go down this way, and if you go down this way, you find another set of these pillars that you have to destroy while he's watching, But there's actually a shortcut here that's kind of a bug. And what you do is, instead of going to that side, you drop down on top of these bricks, and you fall down here. This is bugging out the game. He's supposed to be able to see you, and you're not supposed to be here. You're supposed to be over there, breaking through those pillars normally. But we figured out how to cheat. You can't hit him. You're not supposed to even be able to do this, but it does no damage when you try to hit him. You have to hit him in the real way, which is running over here and getting through this pillar without getting hit. There's a gecko up here too. What the fuck? Did you see that sack of shit gecko run through the wall? Did you see that motherfucker walk through that wall? I forgot that Charles is asleep. Shh. Did you see that motherfucker walk through the wall? That was bullshit. Shh. What the fuck was that? Anyway, we get the second ballista. Now that we got the second ballista, he's trapped. So now we hit him with both ballistas, and he's kind of like, what do you call it? Tied down. He can still do damage to you though. His breath is like super bad breath. Now he's dead. The dragon god from the intro has been slewed. And here's our reward. 26,800 souls and pure dragon stone and dragon demon soul. So that message there tells us that now we can get through the colorless fog that was blocking us before. Is there nothing else up here? Oh yeah, there is. I missed that item. Right here. Master's ring. So since we killed him and now we can go further in the first stage, that's basically what the goal is. This is like the first accomplishment in the game, really. I mean, not the first accomplishment, but now we can beat the entire first stage because we've completed the second stage. It's a cool system. It kind of forces the player to explore the different worlds instead of just beating the first one right away. I like it a lot. Anyway, let's level up.
Soul of the mind, key to life's ether. Soul of the
magic, right?
Drawn from its vessel. Let strength be granted so the world might be mended.
127.
So the world might be mended. Art thou done?
Need more green bar?
Main thine.
Yeah, maybe you were right. I should have done more green. It's okay. gonna go kill myself in the Nexus. Harakiri, what are your thoughts on DOA? I was watching DOA earlier today. I think that game looks so shitty. It looks fucking terrible. But I've never played it really, so it may be really good. But I also know that some of my friends have played it, like JLP and Eddie Pistons and Tom Brady, and they all say it's trash. Those guys were champions at that game, and they say it's trash. So it looks shitty, and people that I know that are good at it say it's shitty, so I assume it's shitty. Gotta go get my souls. Alright, so we got my 5,000. So now we gotta go. Actually, you know where I wanna go? The next place I wanna go is here. But you know, it's 1 a.m. Lord Chatroom, I should go to sleep. I really should. In fact, I'm going to. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna be a responsible adult. I started at, I think, 8:30 or so. I don't know how long I've been streaming, but it's been enough. I want to go to sleep at a reasonable hour so that I could wake up at a reasonable hour and stream again. So, the good news is that, Lord Chatroom, if you're new around here, I stream all the time. And if you follow the channel, you will realize that I'll be back tomorrow. The bad news, though, is that I should definitely get some sleep. You know, so Lord Chatroom, thank you so much for joining me. You guys are real pals. This is one of my favorite games ever, and it warms the cockles of my beard to know that you guys enjoy joining me for my playthroughs of my favorite games. If you're new around here, follow the channel. If you're old around here, I'll see you tomorrow. Everybody have a good night. Take it easy.